Hold on.
Great.
Terrific.
Patty,
don't.
Hold on.
Sorry. They don't want to ruin it.
Go see if you can find the candles.
It's really great to be here. I know. I'm turning 60. They say that's the new 40, so I'm happy to be 40. And my wife, Judy, and Lindley, thank you very, very much for hosting this. And that's a picture of me when I was with the Knicks. If you can't make it in New York, you can't make it anywhere. Yeah. I'll tell you something. Don't look at the pants because they're very short there. But I'm also most proud tonight that my coach, my college coach, the famed, revered, Paul.
When I was recruiting him, right, it was between us, North Carolina, Virginia, and the University of Pennsylvania. So I took the AD up to talk to Tom. He said, look, and Tom said, I got a question, coach. I said, what's that? He said, Virginia has got 2,100,000 books in the library, and North Carolina's got 2,500,000, and Virginia's got so many, right? And he said, Maryland doesn't have but 1,200,000. I said, Tom, wait a minute. If you read all them, I'll buy you some more books. Hey, y'all probably don't know this, but he signed the last day that you could sign. And I put him up in the Ellicott Hall, and some girl came up to him and said, hey, my light's burned out. Can you fix it for me? Time? She said, get yourself a ladder. I was trying to fix him up.
Team that never accepted a gold medal, a silver medal.
So. How'd they cheat you?
Because they kept resetting the clock three times. This is the 40th anniversary of that game, so.
Awful.
Big time. 5 days after the Israeli athletes lost their life and killed them.
So they kept resetting the clock until they had enough points
they
to win?
They kept resetting until the Russians won.
God, what a bunch
tell
of
people. Tell them where the medals are, what's going
medals
on.
Medals are sitting in Switzerland.
Here we go.
Old picture and your new picture.
Coming now.
Let's give a round of applause for Tom Quinn.
A lot of stuff.
50 years of writing.